Kashmir. The northwestern region of the Indian subcontinent. Historically, the term Kashmir was used to refer to the valley lying between the Great Himalayas and the Pir Panjal Range. Snow-capped mountains, sunny gardens, romantic houseboats, you'll never want to go back. The four distinct seasons of Kashmir has its own peculiar character and distinctive charm. Kashmir is synonymous with romance and has therefore been a popular destination for many Indian filmmakers. Looking at the beauty of this region, no wonder Emperor Jahangir is said to have exclaimed, "If there is paradise anywhere on earth, it's here, it's here, it's here."
And now it's time to have a detailed analysis on the region which is called the heaven on earth. We're talking about Kashmir, and to help us with that, we have the real food connoisseur with us. Welcome to our show, Mr. Sikandar. How are you today?
I'm good today.
So we'd like to know from you, please tell us something about this grand cuisine of Kashmir. What's it all about?
Kashmir is a cold valley, and the people are very cool-minded. And the whole region is really beautiful. It's full of greenery and serenity, tranquility. And that's how their cuisine is, like the people. It's milder. Fortunately, they don't use too much of ginger, garlic, or onions. They rely more on yogurt. Traditionally, there are lamb eaters or goat eaters. They love that meat. And very little beef is consumed there. And their dishes are curries, which are always having yogurts and fragrant spices, aromatic spices.
Well, you've also noticed that Kashmiri food is not very spicy compared to the regional food of the other places. What do you think is the reason behind it?
Kashmir traditionally has used milder spices, fragrant spices like fennel. They have very little use of hot spice. They use the Kashmiri chili, which has a lot of color in it, but not too much heat. They use a lot of yogurt, and they are slow cook the meat. So you have dishes like Rogan Josh, for instance, or Gustava, which is slowly cooked in lamb cooked in yogurt curry.
Even saffron as well. There's a lot of use in saffron.
Yes, saffron is because it's locally produced. It is used in dishes very, very minutely, and they like fragrant dishes.
Well, wazwan, what's it all about, and what really goes into a traditional wazwan?
Wazwan is a festive event in which 36 or so dishes are cooked.
36,
and mostly these are lamb and goat meat, and you have a list of guests. They are seated, four people eat in a plate. Mostly it is started with a pilaf with kebabs, and then you keep on serving people till the last dish, that is gustab, which is like meatballs cooked in yogurt. It's a very rich event, mostly now done only for weddings, and it's a dying tradition. You have special cooks who prepare these. They are expert in their own, and you have several of them cooking all these 36 dishes for one event.
I'm sure it must be quite a task to prepare like 36 dishes in one ceremony. That's brilliant. So Kashmiri beverages are super popular in the whole world, and we all know about that. But we'd like to know from you, like, what exactly goes into the making of these beverages?
The loon chai is actually salted tea.
Salted?
Yes. And it's brewed first. The green tea is brewed with a little bit pinch of baking soda. And it's brewed for an hour or so. And then you add the milk in it, twice the amount of milk in it. And it turns into a pinkish brownish color, and then you add the salt in it, and it tastes very different from anything that you've ever tasted. So it's very popular. You know, Kashmir Valley in itself is very cold, and people like to drink a lot of this beverage. This thing, it's normally had with bakar khani and kulcha. So people, that's their breakfast early in the morning. They crush the bakar khani, which is like a pastry, and they put it in a bowl of namkeen chai or loon chai or seher chai, and then they would eat the flakes with it and enjoy it.
Brilliant. So that's, we have to try it out ourselves as well, because it sounds very interesting for sure. So on this note, I would like to thank you for your time once again, for giving us such valuable insight on Kashmiri food. It was a pleasure speaking to you.
Thank you very much. It's been my pleasure.
Shan Foods presents Sir. Beyond Foods presents Serve. Our first guest for today is Kiara Mudalige, a Dubai-based restaurateur who comes all the way from Sri Lanka. Kiara is keen about fashion and food and is all set to make a mark in the Middle East culinary industry. Our second guest for today is Dino Dramakis, a Greek national who has studied at the California State University. Dino has keen interest in sports and currently works in the Middle Eastern music industry. Which dish was featured in today's From the Chef's Kitchen segment? Was it A. Rogan Josh, B. Kashmiri Rishta, or C. Zafrani Pulao? SMS your name space answer to 6565.